Welcome to Take Two Creations with Manoj and Chetna. Today we have a veteran actress whose known and recognized face has been appreciated for her skills as a fine actor on cinema, television, and theater. But there is a facet beyond her known self that she has been working on over past 30 years, exploring and self-experimenting with various techniques of holistic healing. She had succeeded in evolving simple teachings and principles to help people live life to the fullest. In every activity, her focus has been observing the human spirit and its workings. So please welcome Smita Jaikar. Smita ji, welcome.
Namaskar, Smita ji. Smita Jaikar. Thank you for joining us today. Wonderful to see you. Before we get started into your detailed career path and things, we want to know, and I'm sure audience would like to know, who's Smita Jaikar? Who define yourself, and what is your passion, and where you are in life?
Now, if you ask me this question from a spiritual angle, I'll say Smita Jaikar is just a soul amongst so many other souls. Doing my soul's journey is what I am, and thankfully, because of my master's and because of my spiritual journey, my soul, the soul which is there residing inside me, knows my purpose of life, and I'm following my purpose of life. On the materialistic plane, if you ask me, then I am so many other things which you people have seen me as an actress, as a mother, ye, wo, wife, wo, sara. Jismein itna interest nahi hai mujhe, because everybody knows that part of me. But as a soul, no, not many people know me from my soul point of view. Which is what I am.
Wonderful. So I think, more, as you said, more people know you from your acting career and things, right? The other side, the other facet of your life, which is spirituality and holistic healing and chakras and energies and all those kind of things. And we want to get into that. But I want to comment first on, and I want people to recognize for what you have done with your hair. You had full blown hair on your head, and you have done what?
Well, I had my hair was about 4 or 5 inches below my waist. It was like long hair.
Wow.
And luckily, I've got very thick hair also. So I wanted to donate my hair to the Cancer Society for the longest time. And somehow I was not mastering up courage. And every time I used to think of it, there's some project is to come. So that is to become an excuse. Achha, ye ho jayega, tab main karungi, ye wo sari cheeze thi. So it takes a lot of courage for a woman to, you know, go bald. It takes really a lot of courage. But I wanted to do it from the bottom of my heart for a very long time. I said, now, before I start dwindling, I said, that's it. I'm doing it now. So I just went and did it. And I donated it also. It's gone to the Cancer Society people also. It's gone.
Wonderful, wonderful.
I think you look wonderful. Actually, you look amazing with that kind of hairstyle.
Style statement.
Yeah, it's a trendsetter.
From acting point of view, is there any desire left to do something more? I know you have worked with almost every well-known person in the industry, TV, film, theater. What is your desire? Is there anything left for you to accomplish in acting?
You know, if you ask an actor this question, he's never satisfied. An actor is never satisfied with any amount of work that actor gets. He always feels he can do more. I can do more. I can do this one. I can do that one. But one has to understand and come to a realization that this is it. And there is always another generation which is growing up and coming forth, you know. You have done enough. You feel satisfied that you, God is great, that you've got so many. Like, I have to say for myself that I'm really blessed that I got so many films which made me so famous and all that, which was never in my mind. So I have to be thankful to the divine that I've got so much. Instead of constantly yearning for more and being frustrated, mujhe ye nahi mila, mujhe ye tarif nahi mili, mujhe wo award nahi mila. You are, you know, you, it pulls you down. Instead, be grateful and offer gratitude that you've got so much.
Right.
I feel very thankful because I don't have a godfather. I don't have anything. Things just fell in my place, and wherever I am today, even at my age now that my career is ebbing, which I'm not ashamed to say that at all, The career is ebbing. So it's still people do, still people are fond of me. They like me and they still have whatever. For me, this is grace, you know. Otherwise, you just get, you become a kind of a has-been and you're then wallowing in sorrow and, you know, wo dukhiyare ban jate ho. I do not appreciate that part.
I have never heard that side ever before. So whoever I talk to, all the actors, they always say like, "Acha, abhi bhi kuch karna baki hai." You know, like, "Abhi bhi wo passion baki hai, and mujhe aur karna hai."
Ha, so the actor is never ends. Satisfied.
Yeah,
actor is never satisfied. Right. And then the frustration comes in because after a certain time, you don't get any roles. Forget the role you desire and you want to and all that. You don't get any roles because obviously you got to stop somewhere. And there is where the frustration comes in. You know?
Yeah.
So you don't allow yourself to get so frustrated. It's fine. It's okay.
So when I was talking to you before this interview, you said like you also connect somehow acting to spirituality. And spirituality to some other things like chakra awakenings and all. Let's talk about that.
So let me tell you, I, from the acting point of view, I feel I'm blessed to be an actress. Why? Because as an actor, I can go to temples because I'm a Hindu. I would anyway go to a temple, but I can go to a Gurudwara. I have done roles like that. I've done Punjabi roles. I've done Muslim roles. But I've gone to dargahs and all that and prayed there. I've done Christian roles, but I've gone to churches. You know, otherwise, as a person, as a Hindu, born Hindu, if I want to go, I will go to a temple only and pray, right? Why should I go to a dargah or a church or a gurudwara to pray? Here you're praying to so many forms of divine. You know, so that is one blessing, you know, to go there. Because for me, divinity is one. Whichever form it is, but I've gone there and I've done all those jo namaz namaz karte sab puri tarah se, but andar se prayer jo mujhe aati hai wohi maine ki.
Interesting,
yeah. I don't know those prayers. I don't know those sari prayers. But I got to be in that energy of so many divine forms, which I'm blessed for. Then I feel. Maybe, you know, like as an actor, you've got to be very true to your feelings. Like somebody who plays your husband, your children, you actually got to feel the love. Otherwise, it looks fake. So, mere shayad aisa ho sakta, ye mera manna hai, ki mere shayad itne logon ke saath wo relationships alter karni thi, to rectify karni thi, to wo sari meri film line se sari ki sari relations rectify ho gayi hai in logon ke saath. Because I actually feel that love for, actually, you have to feel the love. So it gets rectified. Maybe mujhe kahi janam lene shayad padte the to get, you know, each role getting the, all that rectification. That was done through films. And another thing also, because of the spiritual angle, actors are very insecure. The most insecure community you'll ever find is the actors.
Really? That's surprising.
Yeah, why is that?
No, because if their films don't do well, if some other hero or heroine does better, bahut zyada insecurity hoti hai, baap re baap, bhayankar insecurity hoti, which I never felt because of the spiritual angle. I never ever felt this kind of a thing that, you know, you're insecure. Another thing what I would like to say is all of us, everyone wears masks. We all are putting masks and moving around. The true self.
Agreed.
You never portray your true self. Now, actors put in more masks. Because we're playing different roles, so har role ka ek ek mask hota hai.
Right.
Right? Then you have formed your own image. Oh my God, how can Smita Jaikar be caught having a drink in her hand and partying and going all mad? So, wo log kya bolenge? So, ye maine apne upar mask lagaya. Right? So, इतने सारे masks, 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 इतने roles हम करते हैं, इतने masks आप पहनते हैं, yeah. तो आप अपने आप से कहाँ मिलते हो और कब मिलते हो?
Very well said.
I agree.
Very well said. Very well said. Tell us about your spiritual journey. How did it start? All of a sudden, not what 30 years ago?
Not all of a sudden. Actually, my spiritual journey and my film career started at the same time. I met my master the very first year of my entering into the film line. First master, okay. He is no more. I met him the very first year of my film career. And thankfully, because then I was so grounded and I was so guided by the divine plan. I did not go haywire. I didn't go mad with whatever success I got. It's very difficult to handle success also.
So were you already aware that you need that kind of spiritual guidance, or it just happened to be, or it were you seeking? It just happened?
Absolutely just happened. Actually, my first master, Prabhuji, was my husband. My husband's a lawyer. So he was my husband's client. And achanak se, my husband took me to their place. I said, you come along with me. And I was with him at that point. He had an appointment there. And I was just dragged in there. I don't know how.
Mm.
So when destiny is supposed to do something for you, you just are pulled and pushed, period, without you thinking. Mm. That's how my whole journey started from there.
Achcha. So it's been, what, 30 years now, you said?
Yeah, 27 years. Yeah.
Wow. Long term.
So, 3 decades.
It has helped you in your journey. At every stage, right?
Not just helped, it has transformed me from inside. I'm a completely different human being today.
Mm.
I mean, what has happened to me since the past 30 years, you all don't know me before that, but the shift is monumental. I can't even...
So, Smita, you talked about spirituality and you said that spirituality has changed you in many ways. While reading about your bio, I also came across something called automatic writing, which I had no clue about. How are they connected and how you got into that automatic writing?
Automatic writing was given to me as a boon by my first master. He just touched me here and he said, go do it. I said, what do you mean you go do it? I mean, it's not something. So he said, you take a pen and paper and every day, just sit with the pen and paper, your hand will start moving on its own.
Oh.
I got fed up of it. I tried for about 6 months. I said, I went back to him. I said, Baba, mere se nahi hota. I can't do it. I couldn't connect only with that other realm, you know, other realm. So he said, you got to do it. You just do it.
Mm.
So when your master says you got to do it, which means he probably saw that I had some role to play in that. So I sat again and one fine day I got that's somebody started talking to me and I could pen it all down. It was just going on writing. Then I went and asked him, is this what it is? He said, yes, this is what it is. Continue.
Wow.
And so it is like a, you know, it's a sadhana hai wo. To usko develop karni padti hai. Okay, now what is automatic writing? Let me tell you. I am a medium.
So
I can connect to the souls who have passed over. Okay, so why do you need to connect to souls who have passed over? Is because we need to have a closure. Many a times it just so happens that people die, suicidal deaths, koi accidents, even if they're old, like they could be in coma for the longest time and last bye-byes nahi hue hain. Guilt hota hai, people hear and souls who have passed over, guilt hota hai, bahut sari cheeze hoti hai, jahan pe unko closure nahi milta. And it is very essential to get a closure because wo jo bolte hain, atma ko gati milni chahiye, it has to transition. Otherwise, it gets stuck in the earth space for a very long time.
Wow.
So, you get to talk or you get to closure this with the souls that are close to you. Anyone else outside of that sphere?
People who come to me. People who come to me are random. I have no idea who they are and I don't even know the soul whom they are connecting to.
Oh, so you connect with any soul if you set your mind to it?
It's not mind related, it's more energy related. My mind is not working at that point in time.
Okay.
So it's a three-way conversation. It's like you, me and the person and the soul passed over. So I can sense it. I can see also many a times, you know, mein kya pehna hai. You know, and I can sense it. Like I'll tell you one incident where this lady had come and she wanted to connect with her husband. And as soon as I connected to the soul, I felt a lot of body pain. So I asked her, I said, I'm feeling extreme body pain. How did he die? So he said he was an architect and he was on a site. Pair pisal ke kuch 17th floor or 20th floor se niche gir gaya.
Wow.
So obviously there must be pain because the bones must have broken or jo bhi hua hoga. So that these are the kind of signals I get. Then another case I had, another lady who had come to me, she wanted to find out how her father was. How is my father? I just want to know that much. I don't want to know. So her name was Gulnaz. So when I connected to her father, all that was coming was just Gul, Gul, Gul. Aage kuch ja hi nahi raha tha. So I said, I thought the soul is not ready to come, or you know, some, or maybe I'm not connected properly. Kya ho gaya? So I told her, I said, Gulnaz, it's just coming, Gul, Gul, Gul. Aage hi nahi ja raha hai. She burst out crying, and I didn't know what the hell happened because I didn't know where I thought I made a mistake. Yeah, kya, you know, dar lagta hai. Suddenly she started hobbing, crying, bawling. I said, what happened? I gave her water and everything. So shant kiya. I said, what happened? You see, my father is to stammer.
So
that Gulnaz came, he always used to, you know, gul 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 gul. I mean, wow. You know, these are validations, kind of validations.
Wow.
So I have had amazing experiences with auto writing.
Okay, yeah. So I have a question. So I have been laughed at by many people because I tell them that sometimes when I am going through a very, very difficult time, I see my father because I was very close to him. He's my mentor. I am what he made me. So I'm totally what he taught me and he made of me. So sometimes when I'm going through very tough times, I'll just sit in a corner and middle of the night, I actually can see him. So people like look at me with this belief, ke aise kaise ho sakta hai? How can you see? So is it possible to see or is it just my subconscious mind creating an image?
He's trying to make contact with you.
Okay.
How long ago did he pass away?
He departed about 18 years ago. Yeah, but he still comes to me.
Around. So there must be something else also where he needs a closure.
Okay.
You have to let him go.
that's interesting.
Okay. So that's my issue, actually. I can't let people go. I have a big separation issue. So I guess that.
So that must be coming up from some childhood trauma of yours.
Yes, it is. It is connected to that.
Yeah. So, because he has to move on also.
Okay.
So you can...
So it's not a good thing to keep calling him.
It's not.
So at some point in time, let him allow him to...
It's so fascinating. This topic is fascinating. Amazing. But what I want to know from you is, from your experiences, how often are you able to connect with the souls that people ask you to connect with, and how often you don't connect with the souls?
Well, I can connect with anybody anytime.
But are those souls, as you see, as they say in Hinduism, ki people reincarnate, right? So are these souls not going into another body, or they still roam around for
a soul? By and large, to take next life, it takes them about 25 to 30 years.
Achha.
Cases of reincarnation where from your last birth you've come into this birth, like immediate past birth to this birth, are rare. So we hear about rare cases of reincarnation where they remember their immediate past birth. Now if we all start remembering our immediate past birth, if we immediately came back from the last birth to this birth, and if most souls start remembering what the hell happened and with whom and all that, it will be impossible for us to live.
Yes.
I see. So I have a friend, and I always question. I mean, I trusted my friend that he won't lie or make up some of his story, but his brother recalled his past life back in India. So that I believed it, but I still don't know how that mechanism works. as you mentioned.
Now there is this therapy, past life regression therapy. Yeah. Now, in the past life regression therapy, you go into this past life regression therapist only if you have an issue. So it is a therapy. Okay. But if somebody just suddenly recalls something from some past, it is also God gifted, or it could be that this soul has reincarnated immediately from his last birth.
I see. I see.
Some people have this kind of a gift. वो जो ये इसको gift बोलेंगे, उसको वरदान बोलेंगे, boon बोलेंगे, कि उसको किसी जन्म का कुछ याद आ रहा है.
अच्छा 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 अच्छा.
So ये हर किसी को तो याद नहीं आता. Like suppose.
हम ना कुछ.
So, जैसे मैंने अपना एग्जाम्पल बताया, तो जैसे मेरे साथ होता है, मैंने बहुत लोगों को नहीं सुना कि ऐसे होता है. तो लाइक यू सेड, लेट गो इज दैट दैट्स द बेस्ट वे टू डू इट. और
या लेटिंग गो, यू हैव टू लेट गो, अदरवाइज हाउ एल्स आर यू गोइंग टू गो, हाउ एल्स.
सो दैट्स इट,
यू आर ब्रिंगिंग हिम डाउन.
सो दैट्स द वे ऑफ थेरेपी.
या दैट दिस ऑटो राइटिंग इज अ थेरेपी. ऑटो राइटिंग इज अ हीलिंग प्रोसेस. Again, when people come for auto writing, we have to remember that they're not gods, they're not astrologers. People ask astrology-related questions, ki main ye career loo, wo career loo, they are not into all that. And again, God, ki main unko poochu, mene, they, Bhagwan, they're souls, they're not gods. To understand that facet also, you know. So,
so do souls come to you searching for something even when the third person is not present?
No. I don't keep that zone open at all because I don't want any soul just coming into me. Just kabhi uska marzi aayega. I don't do that.
Oh, yeah. So you can control that.
Yeah.
I you control when you want to do it.
So
I'm assuming
that energy, any energy, like if I'm a great Reiki grandmaster, I've got so many other modalities, chakra, this, that, and the other. So I connect to that energy only when I need it. All the time, I'm not connected to all these kind of energies. No, I won't be able to exist.
Right. You'll go crazy, right? If you start doing that.
It's not possible. Yeah. It's not really possible to do that.
I want to move on to chakras energy. But before I move to that, I want to follow up on Chetna's conversation about letting go. How do you let people go?
That's a thing you have to... That's where the spiritual angle comes in.
Achcha.
Forget people. We are so attached to our things also. So attached to the cars and my pen and my house and maine itne saalon se ye sab cheeze collect karke rakhi thi. Kitna attachment hota hai apna.
Attached to people also, right? Live people as well as dead people. Yeah.
It's a matter of attachment, and I recognize that in me because I am very attached. It's very hard for me to let go of my human attachments. Yeah. It's not with materialistic, but like relationships, very attached to them.
Yeah.
Because in the bargain, you suffer.
Oh, yeah, I do. I do all the time. Yes. Okay.
So, if you want to be at peace, you have to learn how to let go. And if you can't do it yourself, you have to speak to the divine. You have to raise your... All these things happen only when you raise your spiritual consciousness level. Nothing is so easy. Forgiving is not very easy.
So, when you raise your spiritual level, do the chakras help?
Only the chakras help.
Okay. So okay.
Chakras is your ABC of your spiritual journey, growth, whatever. That is your base. That is your foundation. When you align your chakras properly, when they're activated properly, after that, you do any modality you want. You will be an edge above everybody else. And this is not what I'm saying, not because I do the chakra classes. This is given in the Vedas and the Puranas. And the Upanishads.
So what I have seen is there is always a constant struggle between the spiritual self and your human self. You know, what I feel is the conscious and the subconscious is always in a constant struggle. My logical mind says that, okay, attachment is bad, or I understand all that. But to actually do it, my selfish soul always tells me, nahi, oh, mere bachche hain, mere dad hain, you know, yeah, jo bhi hai. Unse attachment rakhni hai. So how do you, I don't know how to do that. Or a lot of people don't know how to do that.
Yeah. Don't be indifferent, but you need to be detached.
Okay.
With detachment, you love more. It doesn't hurt you. I would like to give an analogy here. I don't know if you'll understand or you'll be able to put this in perspective, but I will tell you. Like it's the difference between empathy and sympathy.
Mm-hmm.
You know the difference between empathy and sympathy?
Mm-hmm.
When you're sympathetic towards somebody, like suppose if somebody's fallen in well, your friend has fallen in the well, and out of sympathy, you also jump in the well to give him, you know, like moral support. That is sympathy.
Yeah.
But empathy that you, oh, he's fallen in the well, I will go and get some help from somewhere and I'll pull him out. Is empathy.
Yes.
Right.
So it is stupidity to be sympathetic, actually.
Right.
Yes.
It's good to be empathetic. So this is the difference between detachment and indifference.
Yes. So very well said.
So you'll be detached. You be there. I mean, that is the duty you have to perform. You have to love your family or whoever you love, whatever you love. But if you're attached, then when they're not there or they've gone for studies somewhere or children, you're finished, you're shattered. And they've got to move on. How long are you going to keep your children or your family or whoever?
So in your for comfort for me. Been there, done that.
Selfish, actually.
Yeah.
That is selfishness on our part.
How do you awaken your chakra energies? I know it's a science, it's a practice and things, but can you just explain a little bit in your words, what is chakra energy and how you awaken it?
So chakras are 7 energy centers in our body. We have many chakras, but these are the main 7. If you work on them, the rest of it takes care of itself, the rest of the other smaller chakras. Okay, these are the 7 main energy centers in our body. Starting from the perineum of your body, like where your body touches the seat, it's very close to the anus. From there is the Mooladhara chakra, right up to here is the Sahasrara. There are 7. Okay. Now, these chakras work on your physical, mental, physiological, psychological, spiritual, emotional, relationships, financial, every aspect of your life, whether it is materialistic or non-materialistic. If you have your chakras aligned, 80 to 85% of your problems will be solved. Each chakra has a virtue. Each chakra is connected to the 5 elements. Each chakra is connected to the endocrine gland. And what happens when you activate your chakras is something you have to do it for you to know what it is. Now, how to do it? Now, I take a chakra class, full 2-day workshop. It's a standalone chakra class. Even online and all that, I've been working on it, but it's, you know, like 2-day and all that stuff. Anyway, that's another thing. But for the time being, I have got on my YouTube Chakra Guide for Beginners.
Okay.
If you follow that, and even if you start doing the chakra meditation, that will also work. In 15 days time, you will know the difference yourself.
So is it a point, and I will watch that, and I will ask our audience to watch that as well. So do you realize that this chakra is awakened or this chakra is activated? Rather, activated is the right word probably, right?
You don't realize.
You realize.
For that, you got to be really on a very,
high level.
But yes, some people do feel the vibrations on the body. So if you dissect the body, you can't see the chakras in the body.
Right. It's not a physical
It's energy. Thing. I think it's energy. Energies, right?
Energy.
Yeah.
So, but you do feel it on your body. You feel the sense of something vibrating at the navel chakra.
Oh, really? Vibrating.
Yeah, you do feel that. Not in this first month or something like that, obviously not.
Right.
But if you like work on it, I've been doing the chakra meditation for the past 35 years without fail.
Every day.
So people are very keen on having their kundalini awakened,
yes.
Third eye, all that is all. They say that, okay, I come to my class and I'll awaken your kundalini, I'll open your third eye. No one can open your third eye. No one can awaken your kundalini. It is your own effort which will happen. By default, your third eye will open if your chakras are open.
So I have felt in my yoga class and some classes that I take, and I've done this several times, tried to do things like that and raise my energy level. So I have feel sensation in my head so many times. I don't know what that means. And I don't know if it transformed into something else. So how it benefited me, I have no idea. But exactly. I have felt the sensation.
Because wo gyan nahi hai, it has happened for a little time. But if you constantly do it, if you regularly do it, when your third eye open, you get a boon. Hare ko ek vardan upar wala deta hai. A boon. What boon you will have, I don't know. But the third eye opens, everybody gets a boon.
Achha.
So what is your purpose of life? Accordingly, aapko wo boon milega.
So is ESP also connected to this somehow?
See, all these ESPs and all these things, whatever you're saying, is all these are foreign concepts.
Okay.
Mm.
Extrasensory perception, no?
Right. Mm.
Yeah.
Yep.
So it is known as extrasensory. You can opening of the third eye, you can say, okay, it's ESP. These are foreign terminology.
Okay.
ये जो बोलते हैं थर्ड आई उसको जो आज्ञा चक्र है वो अपना आज्ञा चक्र है सो उसको अभी क्या हो गया है विद द वेस्टर्नर्स दे हैव योग का योगा करके कुंडलिनी योगा एंड फायर योगा एंड हॉट योगा एंड फलाना योगा करके हमको रीपैकिंग करके हम ही को ही बेचते हैं वी आर लैपिंग इट अप सो आई एम नॉट सो मच इनटू ऑल दिस आई प्रिफर द इंडियन थिंग बिकॉज दिस इज आवर कल्चर आया उगम उसका सब इधर ही होता है अपने यहाँ पे सो आई डोंट कनेक्ट सो मच विद एंजल रीडिंग एंड टैरो एंड ऑल आई डोंट कनेक्ट सो मच विद दैट आई वुड रादर कनेक्ट समथिंग व्हिच इज मोर अपना जो
क्लोजर टू यू
सो आई हर्ड यू से दैट यू आर आल्सो अ रेकी मास्टर एंड आई एम लाइक अ बिग बिलीवर इन रेकी because from like again I'll bring in my personal experience because when I look at people I see colors to me, people represent colors. I can also see, I also feel like there is a circle of energy around me. And when people, if a negative energy person tries to encroach, I can feel almost like a spark in me. So what I try is I keep them outside my circle of energies. So is that something that, is it real or is it like I'm just imagining it?
No. Why do you doubt yourself?
Because I keep on telling her you're imagining all these things. You're just going crazy.
Because he's the one who keeps telling me he's crazy. You are crazy.
No, don't doubt yourself. These things can happen to anybody and everybody. So don't doubt yourself. But I would say at the same time, if these things are happening, you have to be careful. And if you do the chakra meditation, at least it will stabilize you.
Okay.
Chakra meditation by default strengthens your aura.
Because I feel that sometimes my disturbance comes from like knowing or understanding energies around me too much. Like you were saying, like if you pay attention to too many souls around you, then it'll bother you, right? It'll just make you go crazy. And sometimes it does because I'm literally seeing like this circle where spark is happening when people are around me because those energies bother me.
You don't know how to protect yourself.
So how do I protect myself?
Chakra dhyana is the only way you do it.
Chakra?
Chakra meditation.
Okay.
Chakra
meditation. I'll try that.
So I was going to ask you, key energies, jo hain, energies are basically controlled by your mind, right? No. So mind is the center of your energy control? Nahi, achha. Aapke hisab se kya hai?
Nothing to do with the energies. Mind cannot identify them.
Achha.
Beyond mind level.
Okay.
If you put a mind to it, that energy will be tainted.
Hmm. So who's managing energy in yourself?
Okay, good. Now we come to the metaphysical part of you. So what is metaphysical? What is meta? Meta is something which cannot be quantified, which cannot be identified, which cannot be seen, but it can be felt. So a mind is metaphysical. Nobody has seen it. Nobody knows where it is. Nobody where it's come from. Your thoughts, your feelings, metaphysical.
Mm-hmm.
Soul, metaphysical.
Mm-hmm.
So we, most of the time, 99% of the time, we are actually living in the metaphysical.
Mm.
And 1% we are living in the physical world, whereby this is the body. It needs to be covered. It needs to be fed. It needs to be taken care of.
Mm-hmm.
But we have not really understood how to What is this coming to? Like we've never realized that we live in the metaphysical. We are so carried away by that 1%, 2% of the materialistic world that we are living in. We are just engrossed in, if I have to dress up, if I have to wear clothes, they have to be branded. If I have to wear a bag, I have to have a branded bag. I have to have branded this. I have to have a fancy car. If I have to move around in cars, I can't go in a smaller ordinary car. I have to have a big. So we are constantly living only in the materialistic, we've forgotten the metaphysical part of you.
Mm.
We do not give any attention to our feelings. We do not give, the self again is metaphysical. We are so gone far away from the self.
Mm.
Coming to the virus, corona also is a metaphysical virus.
That's interesting. Explain that, please.
Can you see it? Can you quantify it? Can you do anything about it? You don't know who gets it, who doesn't get it.
But there is physical aspect to it, right? It is a physical thing that you can see it not with our naked eyes, but it is something that can be quantified.
If you could, we could have stopped it. Nobody knows. Nobody knows the vaccine for it. Nobody knows the medicine for it.
It will be developed, right? It will be there just like flu.
As of now, right.
Right.
So talk of now.
Right.
It's been 6 months. Nothing has been done about it. Nothing. Nobody knows. We're still in the dark.
Right.
Right. So it is metaphysical. Now, what is coronavirus trying to tell you? Like the video which I sent you today, yesterday. It is just trying to tell you to come back to the self, to the roots. You all have lived too much in this materialistic world. Come back. We are all living in the very basic bare necessities at the moment, all locked inside. We need only three pairs of clothes. Aaj jo pehna, kal jo pehna, phir raat ka jo night suit hai wo. That's it. Fancy cars are lying in the garage because you can't drive them out. All your brands are sitting in the in your cupboard. Nothing. All you need is your basic food that you are getting, which is whatever grocery, go up to life.
So I still am not sure about the physical and metaphysical related to virus, but I am very, I understand your part about metaphysical in general, the energies and things, the things that cannot be seen or quantified, like you said, ki chakra energy. People who have experienced it, how would they, you have experienced it, I'm guessing you have awakened and activated you. How would you describe what this energy is? Is there a way to describe it?
You can't describe energy.
Like
because you can't see it. You can't, nothing, you don't know anything about the energy. How can you describe it?
But energy, jaise energy hai, it's flowing and it gives us light, right? Energy is creating the waves. Energy is creating hurricanes. Energy is creating earthquakes. All these things eventually transform into something visible, something physical. Eventually.
Yes, energy, if you take now electricity, it's something like electricity. Can you see electricity?
No.
You can see the forms of
result it. Results.
Yeah,
what it causes.
A fan, AC, you can see the forms of it. Same thing is with energy. What you're saying of storms and hurricanes, you're seeing the result of it.
Right.
You can't actually see energy.
So that's what I'm trying to figure it out to ask you. That's what I'm trying to ask you. How do you see that energy when you have awakened your chakras? How, as a human being, how will I know that?
I think how I look at it is, I think it's just the harnessing of that energy or whatever, channeling that energy, harness and channel, but it's not actually you are seeing the energy. Yeah. How you channel it through yourself.
Right, that's what I'm saying. So how do you channel yourself? How do we see that this person, Smita Jaikar today, has awakened her energy? Is it like in form of the work you do, in the form of things you do, how you live your life? How do you channelize? I met a channelize Kali. So what I'm trying to figure it out is the difference between awakened energy versus non-awakened energy. I have unawakened energy and you have awakened energy. What is the difference? You are showing it how your energy is better than my energy.
I'm not comparing the energy. You can't compare it.
Right.
I'm not comparing whether yours is good or bad. Awakened and unawakened, yes, I can understand. If your energy is lying dormant, mine is awakened. That's all.
Okay. So that's
I think what Manoj is asking is like, suppose his energies are dormant. How can he tell that it's dormant so that he can see some changes or, you know, like at least he's able to quantify ke kya farak pada usme. Ki agar uski energies awaken hongi to usko apne aap mein kya farak dikhega.
Nee, see now everything, that is what I'm saying. You can't quantify energy because it is metaphysical. But when you start doing energy work, you will automatically in yourself see the changes in the results.
Okay. So I think that's what you're asking, right?
Right. So that's what I'm asking. So that you felt that the changes in you once you awakened it versus when you didn't have it awakened.
Right.
So will I feel that energy in some way and will will I be able to use it in some more positive way or some more useful way?
Yes.
Of course. Yes. How you will use it, I don't know. But you will know the difference when the energies awaken.
Okay.
A little bit earlier, you were talking about that 1% of who we are, we never like look at it. So how important is it to express yourself with people? How important is it to feel emotions? How important is it to talk to people about how you feel? Because sometimes what happens if you show every emotion, people think you are very fickle, right? You don't know how to handle yourself. So is it good to show emotions and express them, or rather than just keep them inside? And
no, it is always good to express. Now, coming to expressing to someone is what the doubt is. I would say, connect to your inner self or a higher sacred self and speak to yourself about it. Connect to the divinity which is there inside you and speak to the divinity. So that there is no, there's this thing, oh, this person will think I'm weak and this person will take advantage of my situation. If I tell you everything, I pour my heart out to you, you hold me to ransom.
Turn against, yeah.
Right. Ye sari cheeze agar hai man mein, toh don't tell anybody. You can speak to your higher sacred self or the divine which is there, which you, whom you follow. You speak to the divine. Take the photograph of your divine and pour your heart out.
Mm. And if I don't have that belief in a divine, then what do I do?
That is the worst part that you can ever do. You've got to that is what is connecting to yourself. Without divinity, you don't exist.
We give different names to it. At the end of the day, it's still energy of some sort, right?
It is cosmic divine energy. We believe in some cosmic energy or no?
Right.
Yes, I do. Cosmic energy, yes, I do believe.
Exactly. Yeah. That is, if you believe in that cosmic energy, that is divinity.
Right.
Okay.
So that's what I'm saying. We give different names to it, but at the end of the day, it's...
Correct. If you like to have a form of that divine energy, have a form. Your choice. If you want to worship nature, worship nature. That's your choice. As long as you connect to that divine energy, period.
Smita ji, bahut achha laga. I can continue talking about this for hours. And I am, don't be surprised if I sign up for one of your classes one of these days. If people want to learn more about your spirituality, holistic healing, and whatever else, how and what will be the best way for people to reach out to you? What is it that you can talk about? And how you can help if anybody is seeking help?
I do counseling on the phone. I do auto writing sessions on the Zoom. I've been doing it for out of India people ever since now. For Bombay people, it's going to be on Zoom. Looking at the current scenario, it's on Zoom, obviously. But out of India and out of Bombay people, I was doing it on Zoom in any case.
So
then I can do counseling. I can do their long distance healing for them. I ideally prefer somebody coming home and I do a whole chakra and aura cleaning for them, which takes about an hour and a half or so. But at the moment, it is not possible. So I can do a healing distantly, not chakras. I know many other forms of healing, so I can do, because chakras, I need my crystals and all that. So that is not going to be possible, chakra healing. But other forms of healings I do. So, and I'm on all social media platforms.
Right.
I'm on FB, on Instagram. I would suggest that please subscribe for my YouTube channel. If you listen, I've got about 500 videos on it. So if you even listen to those videos, there are a lot of your inner questions can be answered. Get an answer to all of this. Like you say, what is transformation? Transformation ke baare mein hai mera video. How to do forgiveness, love yourself, how to offer gratitude. Bahut hai. Even on auto writing, there is a video on auto writing also.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And look out for my message sometime soon. Thank you again.
Sure. I will say a few last words thank you so much, Smita ji. It was just amazing talking to you. I heard so many praises about you, and I think I really feel that I can benefit by talking to you, or like Manoj said, attending one of your healing session classes or something like that.
Thank you. Have a wonderful day and stay
Namaste.
Safe.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.